Hey guys, it's Jeff Lafferty, our cast number 292. I'm going to do the show a little different today because I'm working on something I can't show, and I don't really have anything else to sketch or anything, so I just thought I'd talk through this one, but I was curious if you guys know who this is. This guy here is a dude named Dave Sim. And he did this comic back in the 90s called Cerberus. And his channel's called Cerberus Online. I'll stick a link, you know, on the video somewhere if you guys want to go check it out. And I wanted to, like, just tell you guys about it, talk about it, because this guy was, like, such a hero to me back in the day, like, back in the 90s. Because Cerberus was, like, an independently published comic. And there weren't that many of those. There definitely weren't very many independently published comics that were, like, successful. And he was successful at it. He made his living at it for years and years. He did 300 issues of Cerberus and eventually and finally quit. But, you know, like, Cerberus was, like, a really awesome book, I thought, anyway. I mean, I suppose it's not everybody's cup of tea. But anyway, one thing that was really cool about when Dave Sim did Cerberus was that he did this little thing in the front of every comic, which was called The Note from the President. And it was about a lot of stuff. It was just kind of like him rambling. It was like the if you did like a video log back in the 90s and you didn't have a camera and you did it through the front of your comic, that's what it would be. It was just kind of like about his life. It was about, you know, whatever he was thinking about. It was about business. It was about distribution. And it was, you know, just whatever. If he got into a fight with somebody, it was like in the front of that book. This was like super inspiring to me, especially back in the day, because, you know, I was like a wannabe comic book artist. I wanted to, like, self-publish. I wanted to do my own comics. I wanted to do my own thing. And Dave Sim was doing it. But, you know, like, watching his new videos, it's funny. It's because it's like he's not, you know, like, for a guy who was, like, such a hero of mine back in the day, they're not, I don't know, I don't want to say they're bad, because they're not bad. He's just the guy now, you know what I mean? He's just the guy talking about what he's doing, and they're not what I expected. I guess I expected him to be, like, this, you know, ranting, you know, full of, like, venom and fire, pissed off self-publisher like he was back in the day, and now he's just, you know, he's just an old guy, and he's doing videos, and, you know, I don't know, they're not like that. But why I brought it up was, it kind of reminded me of, like, of what he was like, and what the kind of stuff he wrote, back in the day. And, I was looking around, and I actually found this book that I had, this big old thing right here, and it's actually a book I used to, like, collect a lot of, like, the Frazetta artwork I would find. You know, this is like a Frazetta article and all that. But anyway, in the middle here, I actually found where I was keeping all the notes from the president that Dave Sim used to write. I used to just collect them. Some of it's, like, really, really, really awesome, and I, you know, I was just, like, reading through some of them, and they're just, like, they're so good. Anybody who's into, I mean, even though it's, like, you know, like, the, you know, there's a lot about, like, self-publishing, there's just so much that's inspiring in it about just being, like, an independent artist. I mean, you know, like, everything I believe in my heart and, like, my whole channel's about is, like, in these, like, freaking notes from the president, you know? It's just funny how, like, relevant it is. Like, this one was, like, back in, like, 1993, but I just think it's, like, completely, like, it could be, you know, you could write this today and it would make just as much sense. But I was gonna read this little bit that I was looking at it. And Dave says, "One thing I wish a lot of self-publishers, or rather would-be self-publishers, would lose is the notion that a professional cartoonist's opinion of your work has any validity whatsoever. I understand the motivation of in taking a portfolio of pages to a convention and asking every professional there for a critique, but this only reinforces what I consider to be one of the biggest misapprehensions of aspiring cartoonists attempting to enter the field, that the field is somehow authoritarian or there are authorities within it that can give you a definitive answer as to whether you've got what it takes or not. You're the only one with the answer to the question. The implications of that are very difficult for most people to deal with. The comic book field is not a university, it's not an art college, it's not a hierarchical system in any way, shape, or form. The ideal, the thing you want most of all, is to have a large enough audience to permit you to continue writing and drawing comics. That's it. Don't bother filling out an application, there isn't one. You can be an apprentice if you want, but the odds are pretty good that you're going to have to unlearn everything you thought you learned once you actually sit down and start doing your own stuff. The cliche, which isn't a cliche, it's the truth, is that you have 2,000 bad pages in you, and until you draw them, you won't start producing good pages. Now, that should be very simple, but an aspiring cartoonist will do everything in his power to ignore it. I was not, to say the least, the well thought of in the comic book field when I was thought of at all. For the first 10 years I was in it, in Southern Ontario alone, there was a dozen guys who had success written all over them. Guys with natural ability, a smoother finish, better storytelling. The difference was, they didn't stick with it. While I was producing pages, they were noodling laborious drawings in their sketchbooks that would put Bernie Wrightson to shame. Doing preliminary studies of interiors of comic books they intended to draw somewhere off in the future, model sheets with dozens of variations of incidental characters, airbrushed presentation pieces and cover designs, 20 different logos for 20 different formats. They would draw everything in the world except for page one, panel one. I would finish a 5-page story and decide that it stunk on ice, so I would start over on another one. I wouldn't redraw that one. I'd start another one. One of the biggest breakthroughs I had was getting a wall calendar, one of those with the big spaces for each day. At the end of the day, I'd write on... Sorry, there's my airbrush. At first, it would be Resurrection, page one. After a while, I wouldn't write anything down unless I had finished it. Penciled, inked, and lettered. You guessed it. Suddenly, there were an awful lot of blank pages. I had to work a lot harder, but I realized I had been kidding myself. 25 days of uninterrupted work, where 8 of those consisted of pencil rough for an editorial cartoon or Revolt 3000 character designs, is 25 days of self-deception. Stop trying to fool yourself. If you're lazy, unproductive, you're going to be better off knowing that before you quit your day job. It says at the end of every day, sit down, look at what you've accomplished, and if you actually produce something, write it into that little square in ink. If you haven't produced shit, kick your lazy ass off to bed and hit the drawing board like a bat out of hell the next morning. Early the next morning. And keep doing that until you end up with a year's worth of squares that all have something written in them. And don't waste a single one of those days going to some lame-ass convention to show any of your 2,000 bad pages to somebody who's trying to come up with rent money. Page 2001, no problem. But believe me, by the time that you have that page done, what someone else thinks of it will be the least of your worries.
Yeah, just such inspiring stuff. Totally relevant to, like, artists today, just like it was back in the 90s, you know. I'd like to just read the whole book to you, but, you know, can't do that. Sorry there's no stop-motion video today. But if you're watching 4 stop motion, I'm actually working on it again, so new video is coming. I don't know if they're going to come on Fridays. I might pick a different day because I've been thinking lately that I kind of want to do 2 art casts a week, so I might need Friday to put that other art cast out, but I don't know. Maybe I'll do it and put them out on Saturdays, or I'm not sure. I'm also kind of toying around with the idea. I mean, maybe I should make a new channel just for the stop motion stuff. I don't know. It's all just thoughts I've been having. Like the video. Subscribe if you're not subscribed. Hit my Patreon. That's it. See you guys Monday.